applications growth model, like population growth, bacteria growth, anything like that. That's what this section is about. So we use calculus to see how we apply this this out. First, recall some quick derivative identities. One of them, if y equals e to the u, y prime is u prime e to the u. And as a property of natural logs of a to the m, we're allowed to bring this m to the front down here. And to apply that first formula, if f of x is 3e to the 4x, then what is y prime? Is the derivative of the top, which is 4 times itself. And notice how you can rewrite it as f of x times 4. Also, recall that y prime, we can write it in what we call Leibniz notation, dy dx. That's the first derivative. Derivative of y with respect to x. So if we have a differential equation, we call differential equation, it's an equation involving derivatives, dy dx equals ky. This can be rewritten as f prime of x, because that's what this is, k times y. Y is the same as f of x, so y is the same as f of x. This kind of differential equation has a solution in the form y equals c e to the kx, or fx c e to the kx. You don't need to know where that came from, but we just need to know that this has a solution in this format, so we can just apply it. How do we apply such solution? So in summary, if y equals, if dy dx equals ky, its solution y equals c e to the ky. That's what this is about. So, for example, if we have a differential equation dy dx equals 7y, we need to find its solution. Its solution would be y equals c e to the kx from that equation. What is k here? If you compare this to this, what is k? K is 7. So all we have to do is substitute k7, so you get y equals c e 7x. That's all we have to do. We may look at more examples on this. Dy dx is 5y. So all you have to find is what the k value is and substitute into the solution. So y again, c e to the kx. In this case, k is 5. So y equals c e 5x. Next one, f prime is the same as dy dx equals 11y. So this means k is 11. So y would be c e to the 11x. C e to the 11x. More. Should be dt. Da dt doesn't have to be always dy dx. Da dt if the variables are changed. So what happens? Same thing. Equals 21a. This means k in this case is 21. So remember how we wrote y because there was a y here. So here we have an a. So a equals c e k 21t. So whatever goes in the bottom goes here. Before it was x, so we had an x. We can look at it one more time here because there's a p here, so p equals c e, k is just k, and that one is t. So it doesn't have to be always x and y. So remember, this is about growth. This means k must be positive in this case, and that k is called the rate of exponential growth. So we can say p of t equals c e k t, where k is bigger than 0. And bigger than 0 tells us it's a growth. If it's less, it's decay. So the k again is the rate of exponential growth. If we take k t equals 0, let's see what happens. We get p of 0 equals c e to the 0 power. Anything to the 0 power is 1, so that gives me c. So this means that gives you the initial value, we call it, initial value. So P of t can be rewritten. Instead of c, I can put p of 0, e to the kt. Keep that in mind. And graphically, this would look like t and p here, or p of t. The exponential growth goes this way. So this is where p of 0 is, p of 0. Graphically, that's how it looks like. We may look at an example here. In 2006, the population of China was 1.314 billion and the exponential growth rate was 0.6% per year. So thus, that gives us an equation, dB dt equals 0.006. That came from this one. So if you take that one, percent means divide by 100, it moves the decimal point 2 steps to the left side. That's where that came from. That's what the 0.006 came from. And what we need to do here is find the function that satisfies the equation, assuming p sub 0 is given and k is given. So this is exponential growth. So the one we just found, p of t, is c e to the kt. That's the equation, or the general solution to that equation. So we also rewrote it as p of 0 e to the kt. Note, p of 0 is the same as p sub 0, so both are the same thing. That's at t equals 0. So they only said find a function that satisfies this. Now for the k, we know the k here is 0.006. So we can rewrite it like so. Or you can substitute the p sub 0, 1.314 e to the 0.006. Estimate the population of China at the beginning of 2020. So from 2006 to 2020, that's a total of 14 years. So P of 14 equals 1.314 e, there's a t here, 0.006, and t, you put 14. And that gives us 1.4291 billion. Now, as another part, after what period of time, so they want us to find the time, will the population be double that in 2006? Well, we start by writing down what we had earlier, p of 0 is 0.0060. That's the initial value. That's at time, the population at time t. What would the time be to, in order for the initial value to be doubled? So the final value would be 2 times the initial value. These cancel out. Natural log of 2. Because we need to solve for t. That's the only way to get t down. So that stays the same. Bring the 0.006t down, natural log of e. Natural log of e is 1. So you get natural log of 2 is 0.006t. And we need to solve for t. So t is natural log of 2 divided by 0.006, which is 115.5 years. That's what the time is going to take for this population to double, or the initial population double. Keep in mind, we have models for limited growth. The limited growth is modeled this way, graphically. It starts at the initial population p of 0 somewhere here, and it's going to grow up and get very close to a limited value, and that can be modeled with the equation p of t equals l over 1 plus b e negative k t, where k is positive. Now You don't need to memorize the formula, but they can give us something in that format. So in this town about the disease, with a population of 3,500, disease occurred. The number of people and infected 3 days after the disease first appears is given by this function or modeled by this function, n of t equals 3,500 over that denominator. How many people are initially infected with the disease? How many people are originally infected? So you need to see where is the initial occurs when t is zero. Okay, so that occurs when t is zero. So this means we need to find n of zero, which is 3,500 over 1 plus 19.9 e to the zero. Okay, and then 3,500 over e to the zero is 1. So that gives 20.9, 1 plus 19 point. And then if you put that in the calculator, that gives 167.46, which is about 167 people. Next part. Find the number infected after 2 days, 8 days, and 18 days. And we'll see what happened after 2 days. So basically, we need to find n of 2. If you substitute into the equation given to us, I get 500. N of 8, it's about 3,007.46. And N of 18, I got about 3,498. So at zero, if you remember in the previous part, we get 167 people. I'm gonna graph it to show you. At two, it was 500. At eight, say that's eight, it was somewhere here in the 3,000. At 18, it became somewhere there. So it started this way, it grew up this. So one thing to go back to here in the previous one, this line, the horizontal line, that's the L line, y equals L, whatever we have on the top. And in our case, L is 3,500. So there's a limited, no matter how far you go with this, this is y equals 3,500. No matter what, how many days, even if you put 1,000, it's not going to exceed that line. It's not going to pass it. It will get very, very close to it, but it will never pass it. So here, the next part, graph it. That's what I just did. And for the next one, find the rate at which the disease is spreading after 16 days. So they ask about the rate. Rate, remind us about derivatives. So we need to find the derivative at 16. So rewrite n of t first, which was 3,500 given to us. 1 plus 19.9 e negative 0.6 t. We need to find the derivative for this one. To do so, there's many ways. One, you can use the quotient rule, or you can bring this up first. 1 plus 19.9 e negative 0.6 t to the negative 1, like that. Now we need to use the chain rule. So by the chain rule, keep this number as is. It says bring the negative 1 down, subtract 1 from the exponent, step by step, and multiply all that by the derivative. Equals negative 3,500. Keep this the same. This one, this is zero. This is zero. The derivative of one is zero. Derivative of that one, keep the 19.9 the same. It's basically find the derivative of this. which is the derivative of the top as we started our section, negative 0.6 times itself. That's n prime of t. Now we can substitute t equals 16 in 3500, 1 plus 19.9 e negative 0.6 times 16 to the negative 2 times negative 19.9 times 0.6 e negative 0.6 to the 16th power here. And all we have to do is substitute this into the calculator, which I got about 2.82, which is the number of people with the disease was growing at a rate of 2.82 per day. That's what this is telling us.